All right, guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make modern boom bap beats in FL Studio. So stuff like Hit-Boy, Alchemist, the dudes who are really pushing the envelope for this sound. Think Griselda, Conway, Benny the Butcher, all those guys who really, really, really are pushing that sound and not making it sound dated. So I'm going to guide you step by step in FL Studio on how to make your first modern boom bap beat. So let's hop into the AW. We're in FL Studio 21. Now, what I'm going to use today is Serato Sample. I activated my license recently, so let's load that up. All we have to do here, sorry about the glitch. All we have to do here is grab our sample and drag it in. Okay, so once this is loaded up, we can click in the bottom left where it says find samples, and Serato Sample will automatically find out places that we can sample. This saves a lot of time trying to guess and perfectly chop. If you want to perfectly chop, it's probably better that you just drag stuff straight into the playlist. And it also time stretches to our BPM. So let's slow this BPM down to 90. Okay, and this is the reason we use Serato Sample is because it time stretches it per slice. Okay, so let's find that key. Let me see what it's mapped to. I don't even know. Does it say F3? Okay, so it tells you right here the note. Now in FL Studio, the octaves are 2 octaves higher. So if it says 3, it's actually F5. Just okay, or now I'm saying the negative. Let me see here. Might be F1 actually. Hold on. Nope. Where is it at? Okay, it is F3. Okay, so I guess they mapped. I'm surprised. Usually you have to transpose the octave, but here it figured it out. Okay, that's cool. Okay, well now we know. So F3 is F3 to Serato as well. But usually with other stuff, it's 2 octaves off. So what we want to do is have 1, 2, 3, change. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, change. 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's use that pattern for the sample. 1, 2, 3, and change. Okay. 2, 3, and 2, 3, 4. So that's the pattern. 1, 2, 3, change. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now we have that loaded up. Let's go to song mode and turn your metronome on. It should lock into the BPM. This is a crazy filthy, yo, Serato Sample so hard. Okay, let's make this unique. Let's clone this, hit shift, left click and drag this. Now let's go on the top left, make this unique. This will make this a new pattern. So now I want to do something different on this side. So I want to do like, there's a part where it goes F. Let's just go through the samples. There we go, that's where I want to be. Okay, so let's do. Now, it's a little too much to have it do the same thing over and over. It might be too much. So what I'll do is I'll change up the first half and then have the ending do the after part. Since it has a little bit of rhythm, we're going to get rid of that. Let's find something. Yeah, this works better. Okay, let's see how that fits with drums. So now drums, let's go to drum breaks. And AJ Hall has really good drum breaks that he records. Let's go to his recorded breaks. This is called the One Mic Kit. So I'll show you how to get the drums out of here without making it sound forced. Let's grab this, drag it in. Now double click. We're going to go to mode, stretch mode. Okay, this is at 82 BPM. So let's lower the BPM down to 82. Now grab your time knob and lock it to the nearest bar. So it's a 16 bar loop. So now we can go back up to 90, what was it, 91 or 90? That might be too fast. Let's slow it down. That even might be too fast. Let's try 82. So it's a little too much hi-hat for me. So I'm going to start doing stuff to this drum break to make it a little more unique. Also, I'm going to change my snap to grid to beat mode. Just a little like hi-hat heavy. So I'm going to chop this with the slice tool, hit shift and left click. I'm going to slice every bar, hit shift, left click. We're just going to slice every bar for now. Okay, so let's go back to the channel rack. We're going to find our sample, hit control L, and we're going to send this to the mixer. So what I'm going to do is add a plugin here that shaves off the high end of the sample. So let's switch this to a high shelf and just take out the gain. So I want the drums to feel like they're recorded on an old device. Now let's run the drums through some tape saturation. You don't need to do all this. This is just for this specific song. So if I crank it, it creates that boxy type sound, which is kind of needed for that boom bap feel. See how it's like, I don't want the hi-hat all the time. So what you could do is grab the slice tool and just start chopping and moving drums around. So I'm going to get rid of this whole part right here because I think it's just... Okay, let's just take the snare. So now I'm going to do a little surgery on the sample. We just want that snare, so let's hit Alt. See how like the groove kind of does its own thing? So now let me see if I can isolate a hi-hat. We're going to change our snap to grid to 1/2 beat and try to get as granular as possible. Looks like the hi-hats are on a quarter beat, so let's go quarter and then grab the slice tool. This looks like a hi-hat right here. I'm hitting Shift, left click. So for these gaps, I'm just going to have the hi-hat play. So I'm hitting Shift. Okay, so that fills out the gaps and doesn't leave it blank. You can get a little more creative. Going to change out one of these kicks. So here's a technique. If you don't want to make this so complicated, grab your slip tool right here, this left and right arrow, change your snap to grid to something manageable. In this case, I have it set to a quarter beat and just left click and drag this audio around. And that's how you create little change ups in your drum breaks and it still feels natural. So I'm just going to move this. I'm just going to get rid of that kick right there because I don't want it. Okay, so that's how you create change-ups without like making stuff sound robotic. Okay, so let's double click in the sample and then make sure we have the de-click mode on so it gets rid of those clicks. Okay. And then I like this. So what I'll do is I'll hit Control G to group all these. All right. It makes it one audio clip. Okay. So now you can move this drum. Okay. So we're going to copy this as one piece. It's a lot easier. You can hit Control B now and then latch paste. And it also has the effects on it. So let's hit Control L, send this back to the mixer. You can also create more change-ups by slicing the audio, doing the same slip tool as before. Okay, so now we need bass. Let's open up your favorite plugin for bass. I'm going to use Omnisphere for now, which loads up what's called Trillion. Because I think it has the best bass. You could use one shots. You know, you just got to search the internet for a good either bass plugin or bass samples. So we're going to load up the Trillion library and then load up our bass. Let's go to bass instruments. Let's go to electric. Let's just do a simple studio bass. Plan, but it sounds cool. So the drums will probably need to change up to match that last sample. Or you could just drop the drums. Let's drop the drums. So now we have a vibe, and it sounds modern because we have real modern drums. It's not like an old school drum pattern. So right here, what I'm going to do, because the sample repeats and it has a lot of rhythm, I'm going to copy this drum over. So you can see how much work goes into the drum pattern. So if you don't know what bass to play, just listen to the sample, listen to if it has any bass, and just copy the notes. Boom, boom, boom. And you don't need to like go crazy with the bass line, just copy the actual bass. Let's bring this in. Okay, let's put it on bar mode. Now this bass is way too loud, I'm gonna turn it down. So one, two, three. So boom, boom, boom. Now, Hit-Boy uses a different style bass, but it's like a Moog style bass. So there's no rules for bass. You don't have to use a studio bass. And remember, the sample repeats. Now here's where it changes, so let's make this pattern unique. And let's go. Okay, let's hit shift up, transpose. So it goes. Dun. Let me listen to the sample. It goes. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so let's do B and then up to C sharp. Gonna copy these notes. Now I can't really hear the bass, so let me just boom. Dun, dun. So we're playing fifths here. So it goes E, fifth, E, C sharp. And then we can repeat that, hit the slice button, hit shift, grab your pencil tool, hit shift, grab it over. Just repeat it the same way you did with the sample. So now we can go to the sample. So let's find the sample, Serato sample, hit control L, send it to the mixer. And now we can cut out their bass if we wanted to, so we don't have to use their bass. So the question is now, how do you make all this sound cohesive? You could use saturation, compression, EQ, and different timing effects to make this whole thing feel like we produced this in one studio. So you could do reverb, you could do a lot of things as well. So let's start mixing this to where it sounds like it was produced in the same studio. So some tape saturation. So some compression here. I would still work on the drums. I'm gonna try to get rid of some more of the high end of the drums. See how the drums now, they fit in a spot? You don't need that super clean hi-hat all the time. Let's widen out the track. Using an imager. So also don't think everything has to be clean. The reason like stuff from the past sounded dope is because there were little flaws and differences in the sound. You don't have to be super pristine and clean. Let's add some Abbey Road vinyl effect. So what I'm going to do is record notes and automation and record this wow depth, and it creates a pitch wobble effect. So this is mimicking the the flaw in the tape speed. Okay, the errors that used to be in tapes because it might go faster or slower. So I didn't realize that. I'm recording on a pattern. I always do that every time. Let's do this one more time. We're going to open up Abbey Road, hit record, notes and automation. Let me up the buffer length too. All right, and then move the depth knob here. So now we have that recorded. It's on its own pattern. Okay, let's change the different. Stereo imaging changing. So now it's all feeling like it's from one song as opposed to different songs. So if you wanted to go the Hit-Boy sound, and I'll keep this at the last. As the last point here, you could go to your synth sounds, and I believe it's synth bass, and we could just type in Moog, okay, and just try any of these. This is a very specific type. Let me see if I saved any. Because it has a resonance. Okay, you can turn up what's called resonance here. That's how you get that wide bass. So I'm now gonna go in and add like higher notes. I'm just gonna record these in, record notes on automation. Record it with my typing keyboard. Okay, so you don't have to make yours that dramatic. I was just. You can see with this bass though, the rhythm changes. So you're gonna have to go through and change it to fit. That's how you get that Hit-Boy type sound. Let this beat rock for a little bit. Oh, right, so that's the power of Serato Sample. Shout out to Serato for that. If you guys want to learn more about how to make beats, go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. If you want to jump into all of our courses, music theory, mixing, beat making, all types of stuff, go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. I'll leave all the links below, and I'll leave a bonus link about where you can find samples. All right, so thank you guys. It's Game from busyworksbeats.com. Subscribe if you're new, like the video, share with a close friend. Peace.